office in front of the Roxy Theater. Now, over the years, the Roxy and Home Box Office have presented some of the best new action television. No, not in television, in all of show business. And we're going to continue that tradition tonight with George Segal's Best Bets. Now, I think it should be called George Segal's Sure Bets, because all the people you're going to see in here tonight are sure to make it. So come on in. Meet some of my old friends and some of my new friends.
From the world-famous Roxy Theater in Los Angeles, Home Box Office presents a Nederlander RKO Pictures production, George Segal's Best Bets. Starring the finger-snapping, toe-tapping, back-slapping George Segal and his best bets for this evening, the zany comedy of Jeff Altman, the musical ragtime melodies of the Beverly Hills Unlisted Jazz Band, the singing charm of Miss Carlene Carter, the rock-and-rollin' Oingo Boingo, and the improvisational craziness of War Babies. And now, here's your host for this evening, Mr. George Segal.
Tonight I'll be presenting five acts in an intimate cabaret setting. There is deliberately no big stage, no separation between you, the audience, and us, the performers. This evening we're just one big happy family. In a celebration of the things we love to do, making laughter and playing music. And speaking of music, right now, I'd like to introduce one of my most favorite musical groups in the world, and I'll tell you why they're one of my most favorite musical groups in the world. They're fine musicians, they've got great spirit, and perhaps their most important quality, they let me play with them. Ladies and gentlemen, the Beverly Hills Unlisted Jazz Band! Here is our leader, distinguished actor, trombonist, and male model for surgical guitar straps, Conrad Janis!
Thank you, George. Right now, here is the lovely George Segal. And George is going to sing for you a little number.
Who's? I got it. Okay, go ahead. Quick. Who's that coming down the street? Who's that looking so petite? Who's that coming down to meet me here? You know who I mean, sweetest who you've ever seen. Oh, I can tell her miles away from here. And sir, that's my baby. No sir, I don't mean maybe. Yes sir, that's my baby now. Yes ma'am, we've decided. No, ma'am, we can't hide it. Yes, ma'am, you're invited now. By the way, how when we meet that preacher, we the preacher will say,
I'm about to introduce is someone you've seen on all the talk shows as well as various episodes on television. The problem is he's a little strange. In fact, this guy is crazy. Please welcome Jeff Altman.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Where are you folks from? Oh, that's great. You know... How you doing? How many of you folks here, I'm doing a little psychological research out at UCLA, have been at a Hollywood party recently and wanted to try this silly little party gag? Can I get a show of hands, please? Yes, he's hungry for laughs. I'll do anything. I had a strange experience this afternoon. I walked into one of the large discount department stores here in Los Angeles. As soon as I walked into this place, I noticed the right side of the store, they had an optometry center. Left side of the store, there was a hearing aid center testing an old man's hearing. And I read today in the Los Angeles Times that Sears and Roebuck now has credit dentistry. Take my word for it, folks. These stores are getting into the field of medicine. Imagine what their commercials will be like a year from now. That brain tumor got the doctors at Johns Hopkins stymied. Has Harvard Medical School thrown up its hands and said,
hey, fuck it, we don't know.
Well, quit wasting your time. Why not bring it into the experts at Kmart? I was parked in a parking lot a couple days ago, and I saw something that I thought was kind of funny. This kid, 14 years old, had found a little roach in the ground and had gotten himself stoned. Father comes back to the car. The kid is slumped over the horn. Completely out of town, you know. Father looks at the kid, instantly realizes what's happened, says something to him that I will never forget. He goes,
you're stoned, aren't you, buddy? Yeah, real stoned. You shouldn't do that, you know. Shouldn't smoke marijuana. All the facts aren't in yet.
It occurred to me, he's right. We don't know everything there is to know about marijuana. I mean, maybe one day all the facts will come in, you know? We'll be listening to the news.
Good evening, this is Walter Cronkite. 106 years old, still doing the fucking news. Well, after 25 years of research, all the facts are finally in. It's been found that heavy marijuana smokers in the late 1960s and 1970s have now begun making unconscious barnyard noises in their conversation. We go now to the streets of Waco, Texas, and 49-year-old marijuana user Larry Sloat.
About 25 years ago, I first remember using marijuana. I was listening to Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds on her, and I had, my next recollection into consciousness, it all came around 71.
Could happen. What do you say we go to the Tonight Show for no reason, Gordo? Take a hike. Hey, this is nuts. I've never done the Roxy. I've never worked here before. This is new for me. I've never had to, but... Doc, where's Doc? Doc is not here. Doc is here tonight? Doc is not here tonight. Doc is here. Doc, who gives a shit where Doc is, right? I love Johnny. I think he's a terrific talk show host and a great performer. But I'd like to see him start doing films. Imagine seeing Johnny Carson play the lead role in a film like Love Story. Excuse me, could you tell me which room she's in? Over here, huh? Oh, Johnny, kiss me one last time. I'm so sick. Hey, that's crazy. How sick are you? How much time has she got, Doc? Oh, Doc is not here tonight. I miss Nixon. I really do. You know, with Carter, you have no idea. You know, you just, you know, hit, well, the energy crisis, I'm not too sure. Drive, oh, I don't know, fuck it, who cares? I don't know. You know, hey, you know, lay back, take it easy. We have found through a number of governmental tests with my brother Billy that beer does produce gas. You know? You have no idea, just telling the truth. But with, you know, I miss Nixon. I miss the whole thing, you know. I wonder what Nixon's doing now. I have an idea. I heard that he was on tour now with the Temptations. You imagine that?
Hit it, baby.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, live from the Motor City, Detroit, Michigan, Motown Records goes in search of new talent. Tonight, back from a recent interview with David and the Frostbites, now on tour with his book. You've seen him with B.B. Rebozo. Ladies and gentlemen, now dancing with the Temptations. Get down, party hardy, and welcome Disco Dick Nixon and the Richard Nixon Soul Review.
Good evening, my fellow Americans. I'd like, of course, naturally to say that I'm so horny right now I could eat the taillights off a dump truck.
I like Joe Frazier, you know. I liked it when Joe Frazier sang at all the fights. And now, you know, Joe put together an act after. And now, Joe Frazier's here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, former heavyweight champion of the world from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Smoking Joe Frazier here to sing the national anthem. Joe?
It's got a third less calories than the regular beer. Nice. Roast.
Yeah, Joe is tough, but not the toughest. Not the toughest. The toughest is the champ.
Of all time, of all time. Some said the greatest of all time was a man named George Foreman. Some said I beat Foreman and Zaire. I beat Joe Frazier 2 out of 3. I beat Ken and Norton. Never let them say I'm not the greatest. I feel good. I look good tonight. Look, I'm pretty as a girl. I retired from the ring. Never beaten 3 times. Only man in the world to win the championship 3 times. I feel good. I'm really ready.
Slow down, Muhammad. You're absolutely delirious.
What you mean delirious? Two in a breath?
Let me ask you this, Muhammad Ali. The career coming to a close. I'd like to know if you brought any pugilistic poetry with you tonight.
I did, Seaweed Face. Howard has disputed who the greatest fighter should be. The answer's simple, it's Muhammad Ali. I've beaten everyone, you might say I'm a whiz, and if I'm not the greatest, who is?
Well, very good, Muhammad, but there's no punchline. What do you plan on doing now that you are officially retired?
Well, now that I've had my last fight, come out for my last bell, there's only one ass left to kick, and that's yours, Howard Cosell.
I think he could keep fighting, I don't know. It's just that the quality of people that he fought towards the end started getting kind of dumber and dumber, less talented, you know? I mean, let's face it, Leon Spinks was not putting himself through Yale Dental School. You know, he fought all those guys. Can you imagine, though, if you'd had one more fight, what that guy might have been like?
My name is Leonard Moon. And I don't have the brains of a fucking ice cube. How do I spell relief? I don't know. Many of you have recognized me from my film career. I played the meat in Rocky. I must win this fight against Ali or go back to my former job in the U.S. Navy as an anchor. I'm ready for this. I'm tired of being called by my slave name, Leonard Moon. From now on, I'll be referred to by my real name, Sid Zuckerman. Against Ali, he had to step up to my face and hit me in my head many times. That like my head won't to burst open. I saw stars, moon, birds, monkeys, and old Popeye cartoons. He had made my eyes do a dance like the OJ. Your face all the time, they want to take your place. Backstabbers, party hardy, right on me. Then, for many weeks, I had spent in hypnosis with Ali to beat Ali. Day after day, I would sit and repeat, I look forward to being knocked out. I look forward to being knocked out. In round 11, Ali hit me with something that felt like an aircraft carrier. I dreamed of singing with the Silvers. But they said, because I thought Boogie Fever was a nose infection. My manager, he's my boy, come on, say hi to Tiger Roy Williams. To me, Leonard, if you fall down, stay down until 8. Stay down until 8. Stay down until 8. Now I looked up at the clock, it only said 7:30.
You got some terrific, really.
Oh.
It's a beer commercial.
This is Carlene Carter. And Carlene comes from one of America's oldest and most distinguished musical families. Her grandmother, for instance, was the legendary matriarch of country music, Mother Maybelle Carter. Please welcome Carlene Carter.
That was a real nice introduction. Like you said, I did come from a long line of musicians, and I was just wondering if maybe back in your past somewhere there weren't some banjo pickers.
Are you kidding, Carlene? Why, I come from a long line of banjo players, going all the way back to the legendary Marie Antoinette Siegel, who said, as we all know, let them eat banjos.
Oh, I didn't know that. Sorry.
Would you like to sing for us now?
Yeah, I'd love it.
Oh, great, Carlene. Terrific.
Carlene
something I could do to capture you. I'd do it in a heartbeat. Some little trick that I could try to catch your eye. I'd do it in a heartbeat. If I had to jump through a hoop of fire, even that would be as easy as pie. If to fly like Superman would win your hand, I'd do it in a heartbeat. You got a tedious task, all you gotta do is ask. I wouldn't need a second bidding. If I was printed in the press saying yes, I would not be kidding. If the only thing to keep you from me was a slam bam thing with Ali, I'd get pushed around and knocked down 15 rounds. I'd do it in a heartbeat. If looks could kill, you surely will. You're 103 if you just look. If they locked you up, all the girls in town would be trying to tear that jailhouse down. But I'd do it in a heartbeat. I'd do it in a heartbeat. If you thought I was cute in a parachute, I'd free fall 40,000. And if you thought I'd be nice hanging on ice, I'd climb the highest mountain. If I had to jump through a hoop of fire, even that would be as easy as pie. If to fly like Superman would win your hand, I'd do it in a heartbeat. In a heartbeat, I do it in a heartbeat.
Let me tell you about the War Babies. Individually, each is a successful actor or actress. But every Wednesday night for the past 4 years, they performed as a group at the Cast Theater here in Los Angeles. Not just for the money and fame, but for that moment of togetherness shared on stage. And for the money and fame. Ladies and gentlemen, the comedy of War Babies.
Any pain.
Just relax, Mrs. Brown. Just breathe deeply, and we'll have that tooth fixed in no time. Get that. Listen, Mrs. Brown, if you'll just check with the receptionist, I think we can fit you in, say, next Tuesday.
Oh, good.
You have a nice trip home.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye. Drive safely. Ready for the next one? Yeah.
Punch anyone?
Thank you.
Say,
who
Who are you?
Oh, anybody?
How did you get here?
Ambushed, assassinated, executed.
You see? It's people like you that cause kids like that to die. Me? I'm fighting for kids like that! It's you!
You are a Jew!
Catholic!
Protestant!
They don't understand! Ah, bullshit!
Grapes of wrath. Grapes of wrath, anyone?
Thanks. Say, where's our host?
Oh. He got bored and left.
But he was on my side.
My next guests are as special as their name. They started 7 years ago as a street band in Los Angeles, and they've risen to become one of the most talked about groups around. Well, why not? They're good. They're here tonight not only because they're good, but in response to the hundreds of letters we received asking, when are you going to have a band whose name rhymes with Zoingo Zoingo? Ladies and gentlemen, Oingo Boingo!
you are near. But it's so good, it must be wrong. But if it isn't, it won't be for long. Without you, I cease to exist. If you leave me, Lord, I will cry. One week back, I curl up and I'm in duty. Mission to me, debauchery, debauchery. Oh, Louis, how did you let it do it? I'm in love.
How can you be so
sure? This is the truth.
Does it come from the heart?
Yes, it does. Keep it side. I'm the center.
Good.
Thank you, friends.
And you'll be plenty of that.
Everybody.
Hey, give my right arm for a devil hog.
Damn, drummer's rushing it again. Hey, check out that chick in the third row. That's it, baby. Stare at me. Can't take it, can you, huh?
That chick in the third row, don't stop staring at me. I will climb the walls. Way to fuck up, keyboards.
Oh, God, I think I invented a new chord. what the hell, these Timmies wouldn't know the difference anyway.
Come on, let's keep up the pace, everybody. It's not a goddamn funeral here.
Okay, lead solo.
Okay, third row, check it out.
Settle down, get married, start my own band.
Whoops, missed that note again.
He missed that note again.
That chick in the third row can't keep her eyes off me. Poor thing. All right, keyboard solo.
Okay, here goes.
stop asking.
Wow, great solo. He plays good and he fucks good.
Wow, great solo. He plays good and he fucks good.
Hey, chick in the third row. You want to get high tonight? Oh, I almost forgot. My sister and her husband are going to take me out after the show tonight.
Yeah, there she is in the third row.
Without me, this band would be shit.
Red roses grow, oh my, I long to go. Pluck me like a flower, cuddle me an hour. Lovely, let me learn that red rose rag. Red leaves are falling in a rosy romance. Bees hum, come, now's your chance. Don't go hunt possum, mingle with the blossom in the flowery, bowery dance. Oh, honeymoon, shine down in June, and hear me croon this loving tune. Crying and sighing it, lovey, let me learn that red rose rag. Oh, honey, baby, sweet to me, my heart is free, but here's the key. Lock up the garden gate, honey, you know I'll wait under the round the rose tree. Pick a pinky petal for your papa's pride, beg a burning blossom for your budding bride. Woo me with that a wonderful wiggle wag. Toes to tease me and to tickle too. I do that dandy dance, that dandy doodle do. Ring your rosy round that red rose rag.
Player Sheldon Keller. He's going to sing an old song called Radio, I Miss You So.
Nightly to our favorite shows. Radio, what did you have
have to go. Oh, won't you please come back and entertain us all? I'd love to turn that dial again and get a great big smile again. Radio, I love you so. You were still were on Jack Armstrong, Merton Marge, Amos and Andy. Oh, I'd love to turn that dial again and get a great big smile again. Radio, I miss you so. Made the boats and there's the shadow known. Fred Allen's Alley Folks, Charlie McCoy.
Roberts, we have Paul Maslansky and Bill Vogel. On the bass, our very own hyphenate, Sheldon Keller. On the piano, we have Arnold Ross. On the drums, the great Alan Goodman. Alan Goodman. On the banjo, the legendary, the one, the only, George Siegel.
Been a wonderful audience, and maybe we can come back and do this again sometime.